Smart Wargames here. This time we will check out DCS, the Combined Arms module. DCS is normally known for the high fidelity air simulation modules, but they also released a strategy component where you can command ground but also air forces in an commanding manner, and it isn't that well known. It also received upon release, it wasn't perceived that great. In the meanwhile they updated it, and there was one campaign released. I got it some months ago on a heavy sale, with some narrative also going on. And the normal module comes only with scenarios. I don't like single scenarios. I always like playing campaigns with some connected experience. And yeah, from my first look back then, I booted it up and tinkered around a bit. It wasn't that impressive, but we will do a first look and a review this time. Take a look at the first mission. And I didn't check out the manuals and whatever. We will learn it on the fly, and yeah. Let's start. That's the introduction. The Abkhazian government. It's a neighboring, and this the neighbors of Georgia. With support of Russian forces, decided to invade Georgia, and Georgia is supported by NATO, and you are a NATO commander that is sent to the area of operations in order to assist with the defense. Yeah. One thing strange already about mission 1 is the campaign doesn't tell it you yet, but if you start, it tells you you need to go into the mission planner prior to pressing start in order to equip a loadout to your aircraft. I think it's a bit strange. Give them a default loadout if a player doesn't want to do it, or if he fails to do it, whatever. But we need to equip some of the air assets, otherwise they're simply empty. Yeah, and you have Heinz sitting around with nothing. Also, I noticed on this screen you have a little 3D model and you have a lot of weapons. You can also equip the stations individually, but there's no information given. Sure, it's in a manual, but it would be always helpful to have some basic information on these weapon systems, what they actually are. Yeah, we will go with the setup. It looks like we need to equip every one of them. He is equipped. Okay, sometimes it equips every plane, sometimes not. I'm not sure why. These four are equipped. Okay. But that's a group, that's a group. That's in Su-25T. They have television or optical capability, so we will use some Vickers and KH-25 laser guided weapons. Especially it's in the beginning of the conflict, we have to expect unknown situations and a lot of armored vehicles, and we don't know how the situation on the ground looks like. So I want to go for standoff weapons like Mavericks and KH-25, which is basically the Russian equivalent to a Maverick. And he also comes with a TV pod, I guess. Yes, that's the TV pod or the optical pod. But he isn't equipped now. I don't sure exactly how the system works. Yeah. These have to be equipped individually. He is equipped. For what reason ever. Somehow. Okay. These are normal Su-25s, they don't have an optical device, so but they have some limited guiding capability. They're using it's also something with an L letter. This no S-25L is a laser guided kind of missile, at least I guess. Yes, and yeah, they have the capability to lock a target with their HUD. It's limited, they don't have a dedicated MFD TV for that, but it will do. Yeah, it looks like it also worked out for them to equip everybody. Perhaps you need to equip the flight leader and then it's fine, I'm not sure. But just for the Heinz, it didn't work out. And we have another air group somewhere sitting around here. There is an A-10, it looks like it is an air. I don't think it will start from a bush. Looks like he can also be equipped mid-air. And yeah, that's an A-10A one, it's an older A-10, but we will equip it with some, yeah, with some Mavericks and some 6 MK-82 bombs. They are general purpose bombs. There's a lot of ammunition in the game, but I personally don't like this fancy ammunition, especially this container expanders and shrapnel bombs or flechette bombs. I think they often fail, especially when fighting armored vehicles, which are the biggest danger in the game. So general purpose bombs are pretty good. I'm not sure about the 9M114. I think that these are big rockets. They do a lot of damage but require a direct hit. I don't think they are guided, but perhaps I'm not sure, not correct. Sturm 5, perhaps these are some guided missiles. It's simply misinformation and I don't want to look it up now. So, okay, that's a single flight. Here we have some frigates, I don't think we can equip them. No. And there were some A-10s parked here. Yeah, give them a big bunch of Mavericks and some, I think MK-82 air are these parachute dropped drag bombs. I don't want them. This looks good. He has a lot of carrying a lot of 6 Mavericks. And he's carrying some CBU, I think that's some combined whatever unit, bomb unit, carrying a mix of bomblets. Yeah, we will go with it, it's fine. Also, the campaign, when we start the campaign, some features are limited. I think this also was some criticism. We are not able to control units. I don't even want to control units, but we can't go into them. One unique thing about this combined ops is that it's pretty unique. There are not many games that model modern war in an operational fashion and where you also can see what is happening currently in a 3D vision. And this game allows this, or this module allows this. You can also, not in this mission, but in when the complete featurette is unlocked, you can go into these units and take control. Similar to Steel Beasts, obviously not every, especially the ground vehicles, they don't come with interiors or whatever, with a high simulation degree. You simply take control of them and can drive them around and can aim the turret in an arcade fashion, you know, you have some crosshair or whatever and can fire. So we won't do that much because it's not very, very, at least for me, it's not that much exciting to do this. Yeah, I think that's okay. We equipped everything. Aircrafts are equipped. So go out and start. And I can't guarantee I will play it entirely. I will take a look at the first mission and also to showcase, so other people who see it on a sale or whatever thinking, is it worth it? I personally, we will take a look, but it's similar to Steel Beast. Steel Beast, a lot of people also think Steel Beast is just about driving tanks. No, it's not. Steel Beast also has a big strategy component to it. You can take over units and control them and give them. You're also some sort of tactical commander, and also in real time. And I think both games share the combined ops and Steel Beast share a lot of similarities, and probably are the only games that simulate this aspect in this style. Okay, that we already read. We need to hold and secure 3 key positions and to stop the Abkhazian and Russian offensive. We have some helicopters with foot mobiles inbound, ME-8s. And now you are informed about your air assets, and they advise you to go into mission planning. But from what I know, you can't go into mission planning anymore if you're reading it. So next time, put this information into the prior you start a mission. Doesn't make sense like this. You start a mission and you're notified, yeah, sorry, you need to restart and do this stuff, or assign some default loadouts to the planes. Doesn't make sense that they are sitting there without loadouts, especially because it's so many. And yeah, if you want to use them, of course I want to use them if they are there and they are assigned to my command. Yeah, that's probably the 3 points, Alpha Bravo Charlie. I don't know what this is supposed to be to mean. I think that's there's a street going down, looks like some border station, and which is smoking. I have the impression that it tries to inform me that the border was breached and the Abkhazian and Russian forces are moving in. The war has started. Yeah, it's simply screens provided, okay. Okay, and that's, I guess, the limit of advance of the Russian forces, at least. For us information, how we should contain them, whatever. Yeah, fly.
Leo, Rampart, Sitrep. Enemy forces continue to occupy key strategic positions in Zigdigi and have taken hostile actions against Georgian military forces in the area. This cannot be allowed to continue. Your objective today is to re-establish a presence on the eastern edge of the city by capturing and holding 3 pre-briefed locations. Designation Alpha, Bravo and Charlie. From the 2nd Infantry Brigade of the Georgian Land Forces based at Slaki, you have at your disposal 3 platoons of GAF and MBTs, call signs Victor 1, Victor 2, and Victor 3, and 3 platoons of GAF, BMPs, call signs Rhino 1, Rhino 2, and Rhino 3. Friendly armor at each objective are supported by a group of 4 MSTATs from the 1st Artillery Brigade. call signs Panther 1, Panther 2, and Panther 3, with attached air defense and support units, call signs Spitter 1, Spitter 2, and Spitter 3. Capture and maintain control of the briefed objectives. Further updates will be provided as the situation merits. Rampart out.
Yeah, it would be nice to see the objectives. I don't see Alpha Bravo Charlie, but I remember they were here, here, and here somewhere. So we will move out forces ASAP. Let's move the BMPs. I guess they come with dismounts. Let's move them to this full speed.
Rhino 3 moving.
And also bring the MBTs to. Okay, yeah, that's. You need always to bring them to. What's that? That's some. Okay. Let's deactivate this engagement detection ranges. I'm not interested in that. It's not interested into engagement ranges. Yeah, I think the map of DCS is the digital tactical map is hard to read. You see the contour lines of hate changes, but it doesn't inform you. There's no hate numbers. A lot of games fail at this. Perhaps it's hard to model, but I don't see how big the hate changes here are. They have some, it looks like, some military military air force maps provided, and yeah, whoever worked with these maps, okay, it's a very complex map. It's really complex, but sure, you are responsible for all operations, so you would get some of these maps, and they are hard for the game usage, but you see. Okay, there's even a detailed version. You see, there's a vantage point 1400, and I'm not sure if this is a hate number. Obviously, the maps are different between the nations. Normally, you have this like this. There's a contour line, and the contour line has a number, so you know that's that's 669. I guess is the peak, and you know this contour line is 330, I guess, meters. On the height, and you gain way quicker an idea. If you look there, this is a big hill. You wouldn't like to drive your tanks on it if you set it to map. To see it simply doesn't give you that impression. Of course, the height lines give you an idea that there is a hill, but it. For example, here you can't tell is the area fall is the height falling or is the height raising. You look at the map, and if these are the height numbers, you see that's lower and that's higher. I guess these are height maps of some POEs. Yeah. That's also a peak or a vantage point, was 1660 meters, I guess. I'm not sure in what unit they, but looks like some, I guess because it's a Russian developer, they gained access to. However, if it's an air map, it can also be feed, because that's also an international unit especially for air operations. And okay, we already got visuals on the T-72. Yes, we need to move out. I know there's not much time. God damn it, I don't know where the objectives are. And where are the helos? Are they inbound? There's also, that's important. Okay, they are moving out. They are moving out, I guess. At least they are moving. And okay, let's get some BMPs. Also moving here. We want to deploy them perhaps here. Difficult. That's some village. Move into the AO, and we will see. God damn it, why it didn't work out? God damn it, I pressed everything fine. And now it works. Yeah, it's. There's a, however, BMPs are amphibious, they could pass. I don't know if they require, normally BMPs, I guess, also require some preparation before they can cross water. It's in games always they cross immediately, and in reality you need to prepare a water crossing, even if your vehicle is amphibious. I don't think it's so easy. Requires some preparations. Okay, let's move this vehicles. I guess to this. There's a river. Let's move them up here. And
Rina 1, moving out.
Bring the BMPs as in reserve. What will they try to achieve? There's a street. Is it a bridge? I don't see a bridge. That doesn't make there must be a bridge. If the road is or the water is really.
Leo, Pontiac 1 is inbound for Charlie to drop troops.
Roger that.
Leo, ramparts. Enemy infantry spotted near Charlie.
Charlie? Where? Where did you spot him? Okay. Tanks are moving out. Let's bring also the AAs and support towards this. This will be my staging area. And what's that? That's the artillery. Bring them also closer. They made different voices for that's cool. That's some difficult tank area, but I need to place them perhaps on the if they bring tank forces they may go this way, I don't think. Or at least they could try. I'm not sure about the river, we will see what the units do. Oh, god damn it, what's going on? T-72's move. And that's our staging area.
Rolling.
Bring them here. AA as well.
Moving out.
Okay, these are also under our command.
Victor 2, moving out.
We have a missing. Ah, that's Alpha. Okay. The BMPs are there. Will they dismount on their own when fighting? I guess so. Where do we want to place them? Perhaps here? Something. Okay, he already has contact with some T-72s. If they're getting closer, what they have, BTR ITs, we need to retreat them. Get to this hill here, and to the foot of the hill. I don't want to see you to sit in the open. And the tanks, yeah, you can stay here. Bring the anti-air to the hill, I guess. So normally you won't you don't, okay, they're already in contact. Wait. What do we want to do? Move to the village? Let's fight them there. Because if they have to cross the water, they will be fired upon. That's. Who's this waypoint? Yeah, I don't think so. That's not a good idea. Are you inbound for this position? Why is your waypoint showing so strangely?
Leo, ramparts. We have a breach at Charlie. Take back the area.
Preach at Charlie. Yeah, show me where's Alpha Bravo Charlie. Is that so hard to make a goddamn mark labels? No. Center on plane, but no. Show all targets, no. Oh, god. Alpha Bravo Charlie, I'm not exactly sure, but I remember from the mission briefing. Yeah, it's what's. Oh, you can even zoom it, that's cool. But why you can't give me an overlay on the. It's in Cheetah Scarly Cheetahskeldy, that's north of Ukashora. I can't remember this name, sorry. Ukashora, south west Ukashora, and Chaishi. Okay, let's look at Chaishi. Yeah, we are in Chaishi, we're defending Chaishi. And Ukashora. It's here, Ukashora. Yeah, we are at southwest and north of Ukashora. That's okay. They're all moving out. Do we have all assets? We have some assets here still. I'm not sure where I want to place these AAs. Move them onto the hill. Normally, you don't do that because they are too silhouetting. You would think, yeah, that's cool if they're sitting on a hill. They easily can defend the surroundings, but they are also being easily destroyed. Perhaps move them here for the time being. Move the artillery also here, and we will then go for a fire mission. You dude, I don't think so. Where are you going? Set the guys south of. Can you do that?
Spitzer 3 moving out.
You want to die? I'm correct. No, he's stop attack. We will see what happens if he arrives here. This dude can, holy moly. Okay, they are blocking force. So let's move our BMPs here. It looks like that's our objective. Where is he moving, goddammit? Is he making an orbit? That's always good. Orbit. What the hell are you? No, you won't do this. Move back. Don't set down your troops here. It's the worst idea you can do. Okay, the mission design is a bit strange. If the enemy is already here, man, stop attack. No, you stop. Stop. You will get shot down. Get your ass out of there. Deploy somewhere here. I know it's hilly terrain. It's not good for deployment here. That looks fine. It's behind the forest. Deploy here. The BMPs are on the way, okay, that's fine. We'll fight dismounted from here. What's here coming in? What's that? I don't know, we don't have control over them. That's some AI backup. The campaign is some sort of tutorial. And yeah, you can have 3D vision. You would think, wow, but I didn't find a way. F10 is the button for the map. I didn't find a way. For example, I select this unit. I want to see what. Wait. Who are you guys? Ah, okay. You got set down. Now you will go into the woods, please. Not into the open. You know, fighting, charging an enemy in the open in modern war isn't going to work well.
Leo, Pontiac 2. Boots on the ground at Bravo.
As the mechanized infantry is approaching, go onto the other side of the street. Are you already engaging? And that's the problem. I would have a button. I would like to have a button. I can instantly take a look at them, what's going on. And you would expect this from a game with these capabilities. You know, they have the 3D engine, they have everything, but I don't find a button. You can go through all units with the usual buttons of this game, but I know, like this guy with a tactical beard, you know, but I don't know where I am right now, and I think it's a bit, and also why don't do it? I mean, everybody would expect it, and it would be, everybody would cheer for it. Do some little 3D vision screen. You can also pan around the view and see what's going on there. Yeah, and go into a formation, please. Okay, so this, where's our southern helicopter? What is he doing? He is ignoring my orders. He wants to deploy. Okay, the BMPs deploy in a formation. That's no good. And prepare for what's state red, what red color is it? Is it a fire order, red for hold fire, or is it combat readiness, posture, state red? Okay, I leave it on auto, whatever I expect from them. If they will go into a firefight, that they will dismount, and I guess they have dismounts. Otherwise, BMPs, perhaps they are dismounted. They have no dismounts. The tanks are also here. Bring them into a line formation. These units are not moving anymore. Did they get stuck? What's going on? Like if they froze. Give them a new waypoint. Now they're moving again. Okay, you see there are really some issues, it seems like, with the game. And this guy, yeah, stop attack. You, what are you doing, man? Can you dismount them, please? And don't fly, stupid.
Leo, ramparts. Enemy forces have breached the perimeter at Alpha. Push them back.
Yeah, yeah, everything is fine. What's the engagement range of you guys? No, that's not. What? What is this
Leo,
funny?
Ramparts. Enemy forces have pushed Bravo.
Yeah, they're already in engagement range. Isn't there a button for I want directly look at this unit. Shift? No. I mean that's really the most important function. I missed some button perhaps. Driver roll, left control Z, man, goddammit. Left control Z, it doesn't work. No, also doesn't work. Let's try. What's happening here? What's that for vision? I don't know, some super. I think that's the crazy M8 that is totally over text with my new order. What I'm seeing now is this. Oh, okay. Control F7. Looks like is what I'm looking for. Let's try it. This guy is moving. Here. Control F7 is at least we get some vision. Man, I first need to press Control F7. Yeah, that doesn't look very, very good from a combat position guy. Perhaps we need to move them out a bit towards the front. He is. Someone's stuck in a building. Let's take a look at this guy. Control F7, my fingers are breaking. Yeah, the visions are pretty bad. They can't even watch the bridge. That's not good. Let's move them up. At least here. Perhaps this work better. Or we want him in the woods. I'm not sure, but the distance again too big. It's bad for the dismounts, but I am not sure even if the game models that much cover and whatever. If you will see the combat, it looks pretty. The ground combat looks pretty. Ah, okay, something is happening here. I think I bugged this MA8, but he was trying to land right in front of the enemy forces, which is a joke, of course. That doesn't look good. Are they stuck or what is going on now? Man. Okay. Give them a new order and a new formation. Perhaps this will unstuck them. Yeah, now these guys are rolling. He has also managed to find a way through the labyrinth. I found my way back, comrades! Something is already smoking there. Is that, what's that for? Is that a bridge? Holy moly, that's a big bridge. It's, but something is already smoking there. I did nothing. Okay, yeah, leave them here. That's a good blocking force. These guys are still stuck. Oh, come on. Looks like they have pathfinding issues. Yeah, they have serious pathfinding issues. And the MI-8 is, I don't know, he's bugged. Move full speed, please. Simply move out. And why is there a single AA vehicle standing around? Because he got also stuck. Can you unstuck? He's boxed into this building, so sometimes if you know a bit about AI logic, it helps to give an order like this. But he is stuck for eternity. From it doesn't look very, what the hell, man, god damn it. It's so hard to drive. Yeah, that's, I think that's the AI position. Ah, okay, Stol, no. Control, is there other control options? No. Okay, he has some really crazy AI position going on the roof of this building. Don't ask me how he got his Ural on the roof. That's Georgian secret military technology. Oh, this guy's need a waypoint, but that's T-55s. Are they modernized? Doesn't look like. Look like really cheap old T-55s. Well, we will keep them in reserve. I think there's still. This is dangerous. There's a breach open, basically. Let's set them and deploy them into this dense area here. And full speed. They should have at least a good visual if there are some force to try to manage through. Okay, it looks like we have already people in contact. They received fire. BMPs, get on a goddamn formation, please. And move up towards here. Georgian, okay, stay, let them come. You have some firing vehicles with you. Okay, they also get into some fighting position and move up to the ridge. Where are the rest of you? Man, what's going on with you? Drop the goddamn infantry, we need them here. What are they? Are they, is it, did they fail? Can I do something with them? Can they unload, please? Or is it impossible? Is it perhaps because of the terrain? I don't think so. Can they unload here? And the T-55s? Yeah, get them into, can they cross the water? We will try. Get the AA vehicles closer here. Fire mission, let's try a fire mission. A target. Oh, okay, that's pretty straightforward. Remove target. A target, this what, okay, I don't know what this is, but we know that there are some guys, fire, let's check them. What the hell is this? Jesus Christ, okay, that's the first, he will now see the artillery shell, but I want to look at these guys. Yeah, looks like they're firing. You know, and you see, you could do a lot with this.
Leo, ramparts.
Yeah, you could do a lot.
Armor reported moving on Alpha.
But the controls are so goddamn. I know it's for all games, but I'm right now not controlling an airplane, so give me some easy controls. Man, control F7 so I can watch a unit. And what's this? I want to give me a... Why are there not... Is there no orbit view? Alt F4. I'm about to press Alt F4. Will my game crash? I don't know. I'm pressing right now. Do I need to combine control with shift perhaps? Man, that's simply too complicated. I don't know. Give me simply a button and I'm on an orbit view and can pan with my mouse. I mean, really, looks like not much was put into it, because control F7 is some sort of first person view. It's also good, but and they stopped firing. Are you good? Are you? Did I disappear? That's what the hell? They smoked away. Is that so easy? Let's try it again. That should be. What's the engagement range? Yeah, you're good to go. They could wait wherever they want. They don't need to be that close to the front. Start fire, and yeah, do it. And we will look into this infantry soldier. Where is he? Okay, they're already... There were some guys. Yeah, looking like Russian airborne. Let's see what happens with them now. We hear the artillery firing.
Leo. Leo. Ramparts. We have driven the enemy infantry into full retreat.
It looks like I'm now descending to the heaven. It looks like infantry is modeled a lot. Whoa, these guys suffered a lot. Probably due to the artillery strike. They're launching some nukes. Okay, BMP-2 is coming in. I again will order artillery mission. I suspect them here. Fire. Oh, jeez, I didn't press fire. Start fire. Start. Fire! What the heck is going on? Why are they not firing? Start fire! Pontiac 3. No shit, you're under attack. Are you disguised with the orbiting with the helo? Okay, some. That's also cool that you can see ammunition flying around on the map. I like it, like in command. T-72s are still holding here. We have ordered a fire mission, probably will wipe out the half of the town. Let's see. Look at, you can't do so much and... did I fire at my own boys? What's going on? I don't know what happened. Let's remove all targets. And then at target, start fire. It's pretty danger close. Where's my ruler? Oh Jesus, I can move this.
Leo, Ramparts, enemy forces have breached the perimeter at Alpha. Push them back.
Yeah, relax. We are ordering already some fire missions here. I don't know, are these unknown contacts or are these some...
Leo. Relax.
Okay, something happened here. Oh, did there something happened? Okay, this guy has a silenced cannon. What's going on with the artillery? Are they firing? Yes, no, no.
Leo, Ramparts.
They have 1 million missions, but nothing is happening.
Are approaching Alpha.
No, never. Target radius, oh, okay. That's cool. Fire. Okay, that's the coordinates. Are they firing? Looks like so. Yeah, they're firing. Let's go into the map and see what happens on the scene. Probably complete Force wiped out. Pretty precise. If there were infantry, okay. Yeah, that's okay, that's realistic. If you're sitting in an armored car and it would hit in that distance, you should be fine. Okay, one vehicle got taken out. Looks like this guy here is also, is he firing? No, I think he received something. Camera is so dumb. He's yellow. Okay, they're working with some health bars. Also pretty. Yeah, it looks really similar to the tactical mode of Steel Beast, but to be honest, from what I'm seeing right now, you would far better with Steel Beast, I think. And in Steel Beast, you can also control the units, drive them around, and think. You can fire every vehicle on your own, even if it's not modeled in a high fidelity. And you have, of course, some tanks that have. And I don't know, it looks pretty basic. They're simply approaching. Okay, there are some tanks coming in. Bring the tanks. And they're also coming with T-55s. Are you kidding me? And what's going on with you? Is it because it's a river or because you're stuck? Let me guess, because you're stuck. I assumed it. We will see, perhaps it's because of the river. Yeah, also the AI isn't really working well. I mean, these guys approaching in a column, they're getting fired upon, and now they're sitting there in a column and thinking about the future investments, I don't know. You know, perhaps I can tell pretty quickly if a war game, how a war game behaves, that this will improve in mission 2, mission 3, that I will say, holy moly, what a great game, what a great module. But there's a reason why it's not that popular and there's not much further development put into it. The idea is genius, not genius, the idea is not genius, it's an idea. It's an idea, but you could do a lot with it, and I think there's a market for it. There is not, you have a mod brigade, okay, a mod brigade is something, perhaps not on that, but you can set big maps also in a mod brigade. And you also have combined arms, you have planes, you have helos. And you have a modern setting, yeah, it's Cold War, but that's fine, and I guess I expect that some modders, I already think I saw a screen, that some modders will go with for a modern database. I don't think it's that difficult, you know, you need to rework some sprites, okay, they retreat, yeah, let's hammer them. You also see, it's so mad, it's, the game asked me for cheesing. And why do I have to redo the fire mission? I don't see settings that allow me to set the how much rounds will be used.
Leo, Rampart, enemy forces have breached the perimeter at Alpha. Push them back.
Nothing. You just want me to sit in front of every commander but say, do you want to defend this or defend this? Obviously you wouldn't sit in the open, sorry. This is a good defense position. Here also, but we hadn't time. I don't know if this simple container, yeah, you see, these are simply containers, okay, we can move up, I think. But some dudes already got stuck again. They also got stuck. I have no control over them. Oh, did they? Perhaps they're in reserve. Man, the map is also the scrolling. My mouse wheel is. Is there another way? No. Ooh, yeah. Oh, I think I want to play Steel Beast again. Perhaps I will order a new time, a new month of Steel Beast. I like the Steel Beast model. You know, Steel Beast isn't that cheap. I don't know what's one license is costing. But what they do is they also offer you to buy for $10 one month. Now you say, oh, a subscription, are you serious? For me personally, it's better. I like to play games. Oh, there's something flying, wait. Yeah, something disappeared. So they've not dismounting. Do you need some information? Are you empty? No. It's removed time. Can I have information about you? Do you have dismounts? Yes, no. It's a button. Whoa, holy moly, what did I... Debriefing. Okay. What the heck, is the mission over? No. Is it running? Yes. Okay, that's some button I don't need. That's the only screen I have about these guys. Information, weapon systems, 3D model. Yeah, okay, I get it. I understand now. It isn't, I mean, if you see this, you can also for yourself, you know, war games are also a matter of taste. You can see for yourself if you like this. And one big element which is I can't show you, can show you perhaps in custom mission. Yeah, I don't think I will continue this. It's really, what are they doing? They're sitting there and probably also stuck. I could artillery the hell out of them, but I had to issue 100 fire missions. I don't want to do this, sorry. And these MBTs, they also, my MBTs are still stuck. They're getting, I guess, destroyed by the BMPs with their 85s. And now they're sitting here. And either they have simply a waypoint just for this. And these guys, they are, I don't know, the town is too much for them. Let's get them into a formation again, into a column. Perhaps they can move out better in this column formation. And let them follow the street. I press the button. Sometimes it simply disappears. Okay, don't move too close. Let's see if they can manage this. But you see, don't move them into dense territory, especially building territory. They seem to have a lot of problems with that. Yeah, you can't simply take, no offense, but the in DCS, the flight simulation aspect is of course modeled to a very high degree, but if you have also in a normal flight simulations, you can watch the ground war and you instantly see the ground war. It isn't nowhere realistic, especially when infantry is fighting with each other. They're standing there and firing some super, looks like, I don't know, 20 millimeter shells, and there's, you know, in Steel Beast, at least they show some movement, they go into cover and whatever. I think Steel Beast also suffers. A lot of games, even Armored Brigade suffers in the infantry department. A lot of these games are way too tank heavy, and the infantry is not that great in showing their tactical capabilities and also a sense of self-preservation. They die often, even in combat mission you could, but in combat mission I think combat mission does infantry right, and every infantryman has a lot of utility there, and if he's equipped with anti-tank weapons, whatever, ATGMs, and it's hard for tanks, for example, to go into urban territory, they will get, or into woods, they will get destroyed. But a lot of games suffer in this, and infantry are often cannon fodder. And so you will see this if you fly with your planes. I think anti-air defenses are modeled pretty accurate, of course, because they are an important part of the air war and air simulation. But everything else is simply, you see they have some health bars. I guess it's really that way. You can't expect that there is a lot of penetration calculated for these vehicles. And now they are stuck on the street because of this dude. He went into the building, goddamn, no, forget it. Sorry. I will show you another scenario where we have... Yeah, do what you want. I like the track. I heard it when I ended the last campaign. I think it's way better than the normal track of the menu. This here. So I think way more pumping. This normal track of the main menu, it's annoying sometimes. I don't know, it's so over the top. I think this is way cooler. Combined arms, where the single player scenarios. Let's check them out. Is there something really big? Russian company, US company, battalion, yeah, okay. Let's do a battalion. Whatever. I just want to check out 3D. Oh, please don't say me, I have to adjust the weapon loadouts. Mission payload has not been saved. Whatever. He has no mission loadout. I guess this has something to do with the game got updated and the mission data is not updated, so he has nothing. Give him some goddamn weapons and it's fine. Yeah, whatever, that's... Okay, there are some air assets. Okay, he is equipped. That's good. Batumi Airport. Equipped. He's not equipped. Perhaps that's the reason they updated the game and... Mission, the payloads, they didn't update, and so they lost. I'm not sure. Yeah, whatever. Start. Yeah, infantry is often not quite accurately modeled. They, especially in this combined arms games. Except for combat mission. Combat mission, I think the infantryman brings a lot of... Especially in the modern games, you don't want to fuck around with infantry from close. So combat mission is one of the little of the few games that manages quite good. But Armored Brigade, I think in Armored Brigade the infantry is extremely fragile and yes, sometimes they're only good at fighting other infantry, but you may also could simply use tanks or whatever. Sure, they have anti-tank weapons and in woods they are dangerous, but from the first impression I had, the infantry is... What's going on? Crashed. Oh, choice of coalition. Didn't we do this? Blue. Yeah, you can also play the stuff in multiplayer, and one could be tank platoon, the other could be an aircraft command and aircraft platoon. The potential is there, but it looks like they didn't there's not much use of the control of 7. Okay, cool. Yeah, the F-16 is coming to DCS. Will be interesting to see how DCS, there are only two real modern flight simulations are still going on, DCS, the Big Mammoth, and they do also a good job, and there's Falcon BMS, which is modeling the Falcon, and also some other planes, but it still stays a Falcon simulation. You can check out on my channel, I have videos about all planes. But the game doesn't allow to introduce new avionics, so they all use the F-16 avionics in some way or another. And so if you want really highest degree of realism and to want to fly, I don't know, the A-10 or other planes like the F-18, F-14, you obviously have to stick with DCS when it comes to modern warfare. World War II, they also have some planes, I'm not sure how it compares to EL. I think from what I've seen, I didn't play DCS World War II. I also have no idea about how good the campaigns are, but EL2, they also have some story campaign DLCs, and I think they managed quite good to create a good immersion. Not sure. DCS, I must say, on the presentation, on the immersion level, is not that good. The briefings are often... There are some campaigns like the F-15 Georgian War campaign or also A-10 campaigns. They do a really good job. They are third-party add-ons. They try to do the best with the frame they have here. And you have a lot of radio messages. They do a good job. But this DCS, I think, lacks a lot of character. We would have to make a separate video about why that so is. But they are also improving, especially due to the... You see there are more and more campaigns released, even because people are simply looking for stuff like this. And where it's about personal accounts, and you will take the role of people with names and real operations, and they are improving. It's not like the war in Georgia broke out, defend, have fun, but they also learned a lot. But when it comes to VV2, I'm not sure which. I guess that the fidelity of aircraft simulation is better in DCS. When it comes to cockpit and avionics and whatever and flight model, then EL2. EL2 has, on the other hand, more planes in one game. And in DCS you pay $50 for a single plane, and it's modeled to its highest extent. And EL2 you receive, I don't know, 10 German and Russian planes for the same price. They're still modeled, they still have interiors. But I guess not all functions. You can't press the cockpit, for example. I don't think you can in EL2 press. The cockpits are not clickable. Okay, somebody already received damage here. Let's take a look. Hello? Why is my F1 key not working? I was thinking that F1 is taking... Do I need to press something? Ah, this button. What's that? Ah, okay. That's what I wanted to show you. Yes, we are now in the first person of a tank that is... Why we are reversing. Hello. Okay, space is firing. Okay, that's zooming. Yeah, no, I think this was Ground Control. I don't remember what's the name of the... There was a game that first introduced this command, but also take control of the vehicles, and I like this. It's pretty cool, but... Okay, that's moving the cannon. The controls obviously aren't as simple. I don't know what button I need to press to... Take control. Okay, so in order to drive, it's probably so complicated. Hotkey again. Cruise control. Okay, now it's okay. We are in cruise control now. What can I do with this? Nothing. Yeah. Why are we, when I press F2, F3, F4, I expect the external views of the current unit and not some F-16 going in the air? Yeah, whatever. Let's check out, can I control F-16s? No. Ah, okay. You see, if this button is gray, I can also control the... But I can control the Bradley. Yeah, I try to add different reticles, as you see. I'm not. Why is he shooting? Hello? Stop! Okay. Yeah, that's. There are buttons you can show external views, but. Okay. Wait, perhaps I need to use the button as from the joystick. I have not my joystick connected, but I can imagine they're sharing the controls, like throttle. I'm pressing V. I'm pressing W. What's going on? I hear the engine roaring up, but do I need to shift? Brake. What's that? Okay. Is that a commander view? Ah, that's a binox. Okay. Shift brake. Yeah, if you find it out in the manual, it's stated. However, I think the game overall is not mine. Simply not having the fidelity to act as a ground simulation. But I think I will play Steel Beasts again, and yeah, I really would like to do some Steel Beasts. There are some Steel Beasts lacks somewhat us in the campaign department, but there are some some high quality custom missions made for it. I never tested them out, and perhaps it's time to do this. And where you can also take control over company-sized or battalion-sized elements. And yeah, the AI does also a pretty good job. I think the the pathfinding in the game is good, probably better than here. Yeah, I don't want... check it out, you saw it, you can... Like I said, you can get it on a sale, and there's also... I found on YouTube guys who played the complete campaign, who know how to play it properly, and you can take a look at them. Perhaps it's your cup of tea, and why not check it out? Okay, I think that's it for me. Okay, and yeah, the base game comes with this campaigns missions, and this campaign I've launched, it costs, I don't know, on sale right now $3 or something, or $4, so you won't die poor because you bought it and whatever. And yeah, see you.